These reefs right here are, you know, about 850 million years old. So they're some of the oldest reefs that have what people think are animal fossils in them, which is kind of crazy.
These are purportedly the oldest animal fossils in the geological record. And we need to better understand how and when life evolved, both for our understanding of evolution on our planet, but also thinking more broadly within, you know, the potential for life in other planetary systems. The grant funded by the National Science Foundation came about through a series of conversations with a former postdoc at Dartmouth named Akshay Mehra, who's now an assistant professor at the University of Washington. We brought in two micropaleontologists. One is Phoebe Cohen at Williams College, and the other is Ross Anderson at the University of Oxford. And then everybody brought along different types of researchers, including undergraduate students, graduate students, and postdoctoral scholars. We are really fortunate to be on the traditional lands of the Saitu Dene people. They are aware of our work and supportive of us doing work in this area. In order to get into the field area, which is located in the Mackenzie Mountains, right along the Yukon Northwest Territories border, we have a pretty complex logistical plan. Once the helicopter drops our entire crew off, we're really isolated from any form of civilization. There's a huge tract of these reefs that cover about 100 miles, but we went to this one location because this is where these putative sponge fossils were originally described. And so we wanted to make sure that we could reproduce and examine the exact types of reefs that potentially hosted these earliest animal fossils. These rocks are really unique because they also have macrofossils. So you can pick up a rock and you can see the actual carbon of what was a macroscopic, you know, visible with the naked eye fossil. Of all of the rocks of this age that I've seen all across the world, this is probably one of the most incredible localities I've ever been to where you can actually find these things sitting at the surface.
Because these reef systems are so old, they're made not by corals, but by microbes.
Now, reefs, as you know today, are sitting within the ocean, and yet here we are hundreds of miles inland from the ocean. And then hundreds of millions of years later, during big plate tectonic scale processes, those reefs were actually pushed all the way up to the surface along big fault systems.
Science and a project like this is a real team effort. I need people like geologists who are going to go out and tell me what environments my fossils are in so I can understand where these organisms were living.
We're only out here for 10 days, so that's not enough time to see everything. What drone imaging allows us to do is to construct three-dimensional models. So it allows us to share this with other scientists who might not actually be able to come out here. It also allows us to go back and say, oh, you know, we talked about this contact. Does that contact exist on the other side where we never went to? And we can just pull up the model and actually rotate it, and we can look at it. It gives us a chance to keep studying the rocks even after we're gone.
From our centralized camp, you could access about four different major reef systems that we wanted to look at in detail. Not only is the camp quite remote, but it's a very steep mountainous terrain. Every day we're climbing between 1,000 and 3,000 feet to the tops of these mountains, and there are no trails. There are some small little animal tracks, but for the most part, we're essentially bushwhacking through very thick brush and or climbing up and down very steep loose talus.
That's how we collect our data, is literally by taking a hammer and hitting a piece of rock off or digging into the ground and scooping up rocks and putting them in bags, labeling them from exactly where we found them, putting them in our packs, and then hiking back to camp.
Really, this is the start of our project, and a lot of hard work is coming involving laboratory work and computer-based work and a lot of hours digesting rocks and looking for fossils. This research represents this pivotal time in Earth history where you transition from a world dominated by bacteria or prokaryotes to a world dominated by more complex multicellular organisms like animals. And understanding what's happening, what's facilitating that, what's going on environmentally, what's going on as far as the chemistry of the oceans, to allow life to take this step towards increased complexity is, I think, one of the greatest questions in geology.